It's time for Florida State football. This is the Jimbo Fisher Show, presented by First Commerce Credit Union. The Jimbo Fisher Show is brought to you by First Commerce Credit Union. Now that's local strong. The Florida Lottery, over $28 billion in counting to education. Just imagine. The Florida Department of Transportation, drive sober or get pulled over. The energy-saving conservation programs of TECO People's Gas. Coke Zero. You don't know zero till you've tried it. SunTrust, the official bank of Florida State Athletics. Ram Trucks. More people are driving Ram trucks than ever before. Guts. Glory. Ram. Nick's Toggery, provider of Coach Fisher's wardrobe.
Hello and welcome to the Jimbo Fisher Show. Tom Block and Coach Fisher. Coach, congratulations. You get back on track with a nice win over Syracuse. But certainly interesting when you don't have Dalvin Cook and you don't have Everett Golson, as it turned out. Just walk us through that and then how the guys played in their place, obviously, as well.
Well, then Alec Eberle at center. Yeah. I mean, he made his first start, which is even sometimes harder to do than the other two positions that played. And a lot of young guys in the game. Brock Rubel got back in the game as a starter, too. We had Derek Kelly down. So a lot of guys really stepped up and I say we did it. Accepted the roles in which they were in, played extremely well, made plays. Defense played really well. Special teams were in good shape, except for the punt at the end, which, is inexcusable. But, other than that, I thought we played a very, very good football game. And a team with a lot of energy, passion, played together, kept playing the next play no matter what happened, and competed hard in the game. Very proud of our team for that.
One of the guys, not a first-time starter, but who stepped up early when you were behind and had a terrific game was Travis Rudolph. I mean, he brought the energy in, and you could just feel the life come back into it with his initial
after
touchdown.
After that play was huge, and he had a great day. And I'm going to tell you the other guy, receiver, Bobo Wilson. He had 6 for 69, but his blocking, the way he ran routes, his whole leadership, his demeanor was also very, very critical to our team in that game. Travis had the big plays, and I mean, that first effort just lifted our whole team. Throwing guys off, we refused to get in the I'm not going to be denied to get in the end zone. Sean standing in there making the throw as he got hit. I mean, just everything about it, and brought the energy back, and then from then on, we really played well.
Florida State gets a convincing win over Syracuse. There are an awful lot of highlights to look at, and we'll do that when we come back right here on the Jimbo Fisher Show. Welcome back to the Jimbo Fisher Show. Coach, it was good to be back at home. You had an early start, and once the haze kind of burned off, it was a great day for football and a great chance to see how your team responded after some adversity.
It really was, and just very proud of them again, the way we got back and got the enthusiasm and energy to play each play, and that's what I was very proud of. Had good focus in the game. On offense, struggled a little bit coming out, but that was kind of expected with all the new guys a little bit, and then got in the groove here. They kicked off, and the kickoffs were tough. I mean, that one, they were just hard to handle. Let it go out of the end zone. We wanted to return it, but we had a power play. Just got to bounce that right there, 9. Just later in the game, he was seeing that cut. There was a hole there. That's his first carry. Got to get him in the flow of the game. Here we miss a block. Chad gets beat on the play on a 3rd and long. And, we're starting off pinned back, and then they get good field position. And that's not, it's not real good. But we held the first time. Nice job. Nice job right there. LaMarcus Brutus. There's Javion Elliott again. Getting the ball. Reggie Northrup had 12 tackles on the day. Did a good job. Great job up front. Guys, there, DeMarcus Walker had a really good game. He and Derek Noddy, there you see 91. Those guys all played really well. Josh Sweat played really well up front. Here we get a nice zone play. Unblocked to the safety. Their safeties were coming downhill, which allowed for us to get some play action later and get the post routes. But here we get a little outside seal play. See Brock Rubel. Good job by Freddie out there leading the play. Izzo was blocking on the play. I can't tell you who else that was right there. Jacquez on the play action. We get a little screen pass. We just got to get that center out there just a few more feet. We got a chance to make a play. No, they closed it off very good. They're a good defensive football team. We knew they were physical, and then a high snap. Again, Brock Rubel making his first start a little high. Sean, but I'll tell you what I was happy about, Sean. Everybody talked about the numbers and the touchdowns. I was happy about the game management. Now they popped the screen right there, got us cracked. Guys back in the flow. They get the block right there on Derwin. And Roderick Hoskins trying to run it down. Their guys getting down the field, and just a really good play by them. A really good play. They had us right here. Scramble, quarterback, 3rd down. We lost contain. Cannot do it. Cannot lose contained. And they got in the end zone and got first blood. And we get a nice play action right here. Boy, Sean stands there. Good protection. Read the free safety. And Travis Rudolph out. Now watch this effort. Boom, make guy miss. Catch him between two people. Make that guy miss. Guy gets on. Stiff arms him off. And that guy's going to then dive in the end zone. Tremendous effort. Now, that deal with the energy that went through our team on this right after that was tremendous. And I think it started the whole process of our energy and our confidence just growing right here. Travis Rudolph. That's why, you know, instead of waiting for a play to happen, hey, let's go make a play. Now, here, they did a good job with this. They hadn't ran this as much. This little power play. Marquez White, tackle. I'll tell you what, Marquez played a really good football game the other day, too. Here they go, get it outside. Javion, you know, getting back on that ball right there. There's Reggie Northup. Again, he and Derwin led us with 12 tackles apiece. Really nice job. Here it is. Nice break on the play. There he is again, Javion Elliott. Breaking on the ball, making the tackle. Really good job. Marcus Brutus right there. Here, now we start getting a good job. We only got two sacks on the day, but got a lot of pressure. Here's Josh. Getting to it. That was DeMarcus Walker and Josh Sweat right there getting a sack. Getting great pressure on the quarterback, Jacob Pugh. Now we come back here, get a little empty route. Bobo, boy, I'm telling you now. Numbers weren't huge, but what a really, really good football game Bobo Wilson played. Here you go, just doing the right thing. Sean is making the decisions, getting the ball to where it needs to be gotten to. It's two in a row to Bobo. Then we got a little seal play back here. Get out in front, and you see Jacquez, that big size. Just runs through arm tackle. Such a big body, man. Just hard to get on the ground, and after a while, you get tired of tackling that big old joker.
We saw that in the second half.
Yes, exactly right. Here's Sean, another play action, had a deep post and over route. Finds Travis Rudolph there in quarters, and we got the post over the top and work on those dancing skills a little bit. But it was a good route. Great to see the enthusiasm. Make sure we don't get a penalty on that. Good ball by Sean. Stood in there. Great protection up front by our offensive line. Big Rod and Mavity and Alec Eberle and Wilson Bell. And then, of course, Brock Rubel. Tight end in the four. I'll tell you who else had a great day, too. Freddie Stevenson blocking and reading. Right there, Shamar Kilby Lane. Boy, this guy's going to be a really good football player. Nice tackle on special teams. Big time inside the 20 here. They're trying to get those screen routes. Good coverage right there by five. And Derwin James on those guys. Really nice job. A little crossing route inside. Good. Breaking on the football. I can't think. That looks like Roderick Hoskins right there. There's Niall Lawrence and those guys inside. Boom, got a little swing right here. Nice block by Kermit. Got the backer down for just a hair, and there's that big body just bouncing off of him. Jacquez getting stronger. Again, his confidence is growing. There's a little counter. Look at Bobo Wilson. That ball's going to be a safety sitting in the line at 1 yard, and Bobo gets all the way from the numbers in there and cracks that safety to make that a 10-yard gain instead of a 1 yard gain. Nice job working the feet right here on the sidelines on what he did. Just his execution in the game was excellent by him. Just his, you know, of his craft, of what he was asked to do, and was very critical in the game. Now we got a good second quarter coming right here. Sean back in the pocket. Good job avoiding the rush, keeping his eyes up. Sean's got a lot more mobility than people think. Nice job of hitting Travis on the run, a little scramble play. Our scramble rules are getting better, and really nice play, just keeping the play alive. Now we come back with a counter right here. Jacquez, now make him pay. Don't go around that, Jacquez. You're 235. Run through that thing every now and then. Get a little pain there. They get the little kick play outside. Jacquez hitting it north-south. Got to try to get in that end zone. But that big body boy just keep rumbling and dumbling down through there. And then we get a little power play on the goal line right here. And Jacquez getting in the end zone behind our left side. DeMarcus Walker leading it in right there with the pull right there by Wilson Bell. And Freddie Stevenson doing a great job. And of course, we're in the end zone. That's 21. That's three straight touchdown drives. Excellent job. Excellent job. Now they come back right here. Get a little speed play on the edge. But Derwin gets to that edge. Now we're starting to play that a little bit. Derwin had Titus with 12 tackles and a forced fumble in the game. Here they are here, forcing the ball out. Good coverage right there, Jalen Ramsey. Here we go, trying to get a screen play again. Our guys just playing smart with their eyes. There's Nate Andrews, great to see him back in action out there on the field. He's playing really smart football. Sean, a little screen here. We missed a block right there, and then we didn't quite get to the nickel backer. We spun down, and we got to make that play. Jacquez right here coming out in the flat. That's what he did. You don't realize he had 60-some yards receiving. Jacquez has great hands now. Not only ran for 162, but he ran for 62. I mean, caught for 62. Great catch by Bobo. 10, get that ball up. That's a big play. We're running on the square end coming out right there, but really nice play again by Bobo. Critical third downs. A lot of those little things, keeping drives alive. See, Bobo just kept showing up and showing up. Nice job there by Kermit. We got him in action. Got a little double move here. And, you know, Brock gets a beat on the outside, but the quarterback actually in the pocket got about a yard deep. And that changes that whole edge of that pocket. He's got to be a little bit shallower there so we don't get that pressure and help Brock on that block a little bit. But here, now we get back right here. We were going to get three scores. This was the one that was disappointing. We pop a slant and get it back in field goal range, and Roberto, you know, just hits one just wide left. He missed it and hit it good. Just hit it to the left, just pulled it a little bit. And now we'll get him back in the groove. It's going to be critical going down the road right here. Brock got hurt right there, and a guy fell on his leg. I tell you what, people have no idea that the lineman's most dangerous play is field goals and PATs, all the bodies coming on your legs. Here they hit it. Now they get a nice drive. This is what was disappointing here, because right before the half, they got the ball coming out second half, and they end up getting a score down here in a minute. We stopped them on this drive, I believe. I think it was right after this that they got that drive going. The only inside zone, they had some things going there. Good coverage right there. I can't tell who that is. I know Giorgio probably had an arm in the way. He always does us in practice. Well, here's the drive. We're inches. We can get that backside backer right there. We missed a cut back there that a ball could have popped. We ran a counterplay. Center didn't get the back block. And, you know, we're third and long right here getting backed up. And there's 4 minutes to go in the game. They get the ball, score for the half, then get it coming out second half. This is a tie ball game. Mm-hmm. You've seen us do it many a time. And we didn't execute right there. And that's what they did. They come down and quarterback, it's a little zone read. Chris has got to stay home, make the play. Jalen makes a nice tackle right there. Giorgio, they run a quarterback draw, third down. Get it picked up. Derwin makes a tackle, but boy, they're driving down and changed the whole momentum of the game. Now, we should make that play. We got to make that play right there. We got to tackle it. Derwin and Jacob Pugh, they got to make that play right there now. It's 21-14. Now, this is, to me, huge play in the game. They were trying to hit a hard squibber down the middle. I mean, we work on those all the time, and Roderick makes that. Roderick was a receiver before he became a linebacker, believe that or not. Now, nice screen pass. Look at Jacquez out in space again. I mean, you don't realize how many balls he caught in that game and in yards catching. But excellent job here. Hit nice inside seam route. Great job. The linebacker slid out. Sean got it inside right there to 15. Travis Rudolph, who continued on that half. Now here, we pop a little slant play. Bobo picks up a critical. We actually missed two second down verticals. Out there was a little late, looked like to me. But now, Sean, check this. We had a play called the other way. Sean checks all the coverage. It's all the what they had going to check it. We get down the one. Good thing we saved our timeouts and then got this touchdown before half. Now, this drive here was critical because it changed the momentum, got us back to a 14-point lead. And this is where Derek Hoskins paying attention on the front line of kickoff return. Little things. Little things make a difference.
Well, it is hard to believe. You just mentioned it, that he was a receiver before he moved to linebacker.
Yes.
So, obviously, that's quite an athletic player you're talking about.
He got great ball skills, and they got him to play football his junior year in high school, and he was a skill guy. And, you know, he just kept growing and growing. But, you know, those guys that play linebacker and those big, heavy skill guys that can have ball skills, those guys not being really, really good football players because they're really good athletes.
That was one of the big plays of the first half, Roderick Hoskins with that snare and the kickoff. The other one goes back earlier, and it was Travis Rudolph on that post route.
Both of them, momentum. We down 7-0. We hit the post route. Great throw by Sean. Tremendous job by Travis to get in the end zone. Change the momentum of the game and their confidence. And then that one, they got the momentum of the game. And Roderick got that fumble, and then we were able to take it right back down and score before the half. Was very critical in that game.
Got it back to a two-score lead, so it was 28-14 at intermission. Second half highlights are still to come. Stay with us right here on the Jimbo Fisher Show.
Undefeated Season in Review is presented by Hyundai, proud supporter of college football and loyal fans everywhere.
We're here, live and local. Ain't no going back now, baby. Ain't going nowhere, ain't no going back now, baby.
Blitz threatened by a backer. Here's a rolling pocket by Winston. Going to carry the ball. 40, 45 to the 50. Winston will slide down to the Louisville 42-yard line. Out and goal from a yard away. Sidecar right. Dell handoff. Carlos Williams fumbles the ball. It's loose. It's in the end zone. In the end zone. Who comes up with it? If the Cardinals come up with it, they take the
touchdown.
It's a touchdown, Florida State. Nick O'Leary giving credit for the touchdown. How about that? There's the snap, a good one. He drops back to throw, looks upfield, throws the long ball downfield, got a wide open Travis Rudolph, makes the catch at the 25. He'll go in untouched, touchdown Florida State. Great throw by Jameis, and Travis Rudolph took it to the house. 68 yards and a touchdown. That's Seminole football. The snap, inside draw play, handoff to Dalvin Cook, inside the 30, Cook to the 25, to the 20, Cook to the 15, 5, 10, 5, touchdown Florida State. Dalvin Cook burns him with his hands and then burns him with his legs. That is a huge 41-yard touchdown run by rookie Dalvin Cook. How about that run? On third down and 10, the snap, here comes pressure. Winston in the pocket, throws upfield, it is caught ball. It's caught by Urban Lane to the 15. Urban Lane to the 10, 5, 3, 2, 1. Touchdown Florida State. Urban Lane with his first career touchdown of his career, a five-star recruit, gives FSU the lead for the first time of the game. And how about the pass by Winston? Does he thread a needle or what to number one? The snap out of the gun. Inside handoff, running to the right, Dalvin Cook. Cook to the 40, 30, down the sideline, 20, to the 15, 10, 5. Touchdown, Dalvin Cook, and the Noles Seminoles take the lead with 3:46 to go. They brought the fullback in to block and that bunch of receivers. And Freddie Stevens with a key block springs Dalvin Cook down the sideline for 38. Touchdown FSU and the Noles lead again 34-31. Play action fake on a bootleg roll. Pass underneath. Caught ball. First down of the 30. To the 25 to the 20. It's Freddie Stevenson. To the 10. 5, 3, 2, 1. Touchdown, Florida State. Fullback Freddie Stevenson. Throw the fullback a bone. And Winston does on third down and 6. The unaccounted player. Nobody in a gray uniform had number 23 in their sights. And the Noles put a statement in Louisville tonight. They're 0 for on third down. Dropping Gardner, throwing Gardner. It's intercepted, picked off at the 38, and that's the ball game. Reggie Northrup, a linebacker, ambushes sophomore quarterback Will Gardner, and the Noles streak will continue to 24 in a row.
Undefeated Season in Review is presented by Hyundai, proud supporter of college football and loyal fans everywhere.
Welcome back to the Jimbo Fisher Show. Coach, you have comfortable lead, but no lead is comfortable probably until the clock hits zero. But you have the lead at halftime, and you got momentum back. So what was your message to the team?
Well, I mean, we had to finish. And I wanted to see us play a complete football game with enthusiasm, with focus of every play of every situation, and come out of the block strong, get things going, and just play the play. And not always scoring or whatever, but just the attitude in which you played with and tenacity in which you played with. And that's what we did. Good kickoff here. We pinned them back. They get a couple first downs here, but great job on that. They're trying to get that outside power play again. There's Derwin, there's Josh Sweat, all those guys just making play after play now, making great adjustments. Now, this is just a tough play. Their guy's pushing and scratching. Their guy's a big, strong guy, and he got the one play on Jalen, which is nobody ever gets many of them. But you know, DeMarcus Walker, this guy's just swarming the football. Brutus. I couldn't tell who else that was inside, but guys just getting inside out on the ball right there with Derek and the guys getting the ball. Derek Knott, he had an outstanding game, boy, just being physical inside. Here they get a little naked route. Playing outside, look at that. Derwin James getting the ball batted right back to the quarterback, then going to make the tape. Bats it, deflects it, then tackles the guy after he catches it on that. That's a football player. Really good job here. And DeMarcus got pressure on the quarterback. And here we got a nice little play action. Sean sees again, 9 in the flat, makes a guy miss. Strength, picks up 10 yards. You notice when they hit him, just people don't go down. They're just big body. And here we get a nice little swing right out here. Vicker, I'm going to tell you, Jonathan Vickers averaged 8 yards a carry on the game. Had 8 carries for 64 yards and a couple nice catches. Again, he's going to be a really good football player. We missed a third down right there. We threw a vertical just a hair low. It was wide open. Good read. Just got to finish the play. And then hit a big-time punt right there coming off. Now here, they're inside zone. Great job playing the run. There's Giorgio getting in on some plays right there, him and Naughty. They're going back up top. Great coverage right here. I think it's Javion Elliott again doing a really nice job right there out of the nickel position. And right here on this third down, they say, you know who said, Jayden said, I'm going to go in there and cause a turnover. He called it on the sidelines. I'm going there and call it. We're going to get that ball back. Strips it out. There's your two freshmen. He and Josh Sweat picked that ball up. I mean, just really, really great play and change the momentum. This gets us down there. We can get ahead by 3 scores, which changes everything. Get a seal play out here. I told him right here, you need to run a little harder here. He's looking to get hit right there. Got to get that confidence going and get going. But here, nice third down pickup. Great route by 15. Great throw by Sean in the corner. You know, if we'd have missed that ball, it went out of the end zone. He threw it right in a perfect spot, aggressively. Great read. Really nice. Really, really nice catch by Travis right there. And we're up 3 touchdowns. Look at that. There's Derek Knotty again. And that's what I like to see, some excitement. Have fun playing football. And I love what Derek does. They get a play action. There's Jacob Pugh forcing that ball to get out early. They ain't got time to run the comeback right. Marquez White, who's covering the heck out of him, who I thought is really, really playing great football right now. And George Campbell almost right here. We had a little double move and a go route right there. And we're going to get George and Naquan and all those young guys. You can see he can run. Just right through his fingers. And then right here, he could have caught it and he threw it high. He didn't think he was throwing it to him. And I asked him, who's he throwing it to? I keep forgetting. That's his first time out there. And a great punt coverage we had all day except for that last one. Good job, Reggie Northrup, Derwin James, Gabbert, who's snapping the ball really good. Again, our defense really started to rise up here, just playing great, great run defense. Derek Mitchell in the game doing a nice job right there, made a nice play. Northrup Marquez, Jacob Pugh, good job in the flat. Got to get a little bit quicker right there coming off cover two. quarterback scramble right there. There's Derek Mitchell again. I thought that was a grounding, but, you know, that's tough. They had a guy decently close, I guess. Good job by Derek, you know, making a play. And they're trying to go backside and throw. Derek again getting pressure. Now, this one, we needed, as Fred, Javion coming up making a play. But we gave up eight. We stopped it. We still gave him an eight-yard scramble. We got to do a little better than that. Derek, look at Derek. He knows the screen. At least he forced it. Good job by Josh Sweat coming back inside. And then I think that's Jalen. Really nice play coming back in there. Good job. Pressure. Don't matter. I don't care what quarterback you are. When you get pressure, man, it hurts. And it just makes you antsy in that pocket. Javion getting around that corner. Really good job. Forced it. He and Giorgio forced it back up inside. There's Josh Sweat and everybody else making on that sack. Really, really nice day. Now we start running the rock. We start running the ball a little bit. And there he is. He's set on it. He wasn't down. That's pretty cool. And then had the poise and the presence to see it. Run a little power play here. They can keep his balance ahead of the guy inside, but just everything he does goes forward. Everything he does goes. He's only going to get better. He understands what it takes to play now. Starting to understand. Look at that. Everything. Just 5, 6, 7 yards at a pop. And that's why I liked our offensive line. We stuck control of the game, up 3 scores, eating the clock and moving and getting points. And a little zone play inside. Real nice job again. His big body just keep plugging along. Run a little what we call it, 2 double teams up front. But look at it. See that? Every tackle. That 3-yard run just became a 6-yard run. Just pound and pound and pound. Really nice job. And then he popped it out right here, and our receiver's doing a good job. They're digging out those safeties, making the blocks they need to block and make. And fullback Freddie Stevens, look at that, leading every time, making those. And Jaquez gets it, and look at our receivers back downfield. 2 of them leading him in the end zone. Jaquez, I think, got a little tired. I think Jaquez realized, I want to play. Wait a minute, I don't want to play that much. But go ahead and give me a little sprint in the end zone right there. But his 3rd touchdown of the day, 162 yards, 224 total yards. It couldn't happen to a better guy. He's going to be a really, really – look who's his biggest fan right there on the sideline. You know what he knows? I ain't going to be as tired every Saturday now. I'm going to get a little break every now and then. But that guy, that's what makes Dalvin Dow. What's a great teammate. Just like the other guys, we've always been here in the great teams we've had. Now, good job here. Watch this play by Marquez. Get back inside and actually turn it into an offensive interference penalty. The guy grabbed him. I mean, that's hard to do now. I mean, that's just really, really good sound football. Crossing route right there, nice tackle, again, Javion. Derek Naughty falling back from the D-line, getting back into that play. Look at those guys, chasing the football. 18 chasing it. Inside zone play, Derek Naughty again, playing it. Reggie Northup making that play. There's where Derek Hoskins, those guys just keep getting better and better. Playing good team football. So we stopped him on a 4th down stop, I believe it was, right there, which is critical, you know. That's like getting a turnover also. Now we get Vickers outside, a little toss sweep. Boy, inches, he got about 5 or 6 yards. He was starting to go. You see those guys wanting to play. Nice inside zone play. Popped that up inside. And, again, there's another 225-pound body now. You hit him, everything goes forward. A little play action pass. Get Freddie the ball out here in the flat and watch Freddie. All have been rewarded for all that blocking. Look at that. I think Freddie don't get those tough yards now. I mean, grinds and bangs and just a tough son of a gun. Now, leading out here on sweep, he and Brock Rubel. Good job by Freddie. Go ahead and cut right there. Here goes Vickers. Really nice job. Keep pounding the ball down the field. Play action. Right here, really wasn't as bad a throw by the quarterback. So Maven's got to run. You got to trigger that route for me. Give me a stick foot so I can see the angle as a quarterback to make that throw. But then right here, we got 8 needs to be in the middle of the field and let that ball get out there to 15. We got to see that. We had a little miscommunication in our landmarks right there. And I had to kick a field goal. But again, good to see Roberto go out and hit a field goal, get his confidence back. Again, kickoff down to the 4, we're covering pretty well. See those guys right there, it's Keelan. The guy, now George. George got 2 or 3 penalties in every one of them for being too aggressive. Now, I'd rather say whoa than giddy up, but we got to be smart. There's Ricky Leonard, Chris Casher on the play, Lorenzo Phillips in the game on the play. All those guys. Good play right there by Casher. There's Ricky again. Lorenzo Phillips in on that play. And they pop the tight end back inside. Reggie Northup keep making plays. You see Mr. A.J. Westbrook's in the game too right there. It was a nice pass. See, look how Vickers just bounces off people now. You got A.J. Westbrook in the game, Terrence McFadden in the game. All those young freshmen just playing more and more of them now. There's Naquan Murray's first catch, and you saw him on that punt return. Guy, this guy's going to be – he and George and Devontae Phillips and – Auden Tate, all those guys are going to be really, really good players. Maven out there in the game. He saw J.J. Constantino for the first time. Missed a block out there, but look at that Naquan. He's still making yards, still making people miss now. Still making people miss. Now, this is disappointing. One, first of all, a bad punt. Ball's 30-some yards, three-something hang in the middle of the field, needs to be in the side. And we got out of our lanes, two lanes right there, and we give up a daggone touchdown. That's the first return like that we've had since I think I've been a Fed football coach. And very, very disappointing. They were able to score, and then we get the ball back and run the clock out. Again, you see Vickers right here. I believe this is the last play of the game. Get 2 or 3 yards there, and Maven and Big Red in the game, and Plant in the game, and Peters and Frith and all those young guys. Scott Schaefer, what a great guy. Really good football coach, good person. Really good guy.
Florida State gets the win 45-21. You get back on track. And Coach, I know something you've been preaching to your team is have fun. Football is a lot of work, but it's a lot of fun, too. It seemed like they had some fun in this game.
Well, you know what to do and how to do it, and they just go play the game with them. You got to have enthusiasm and passion to play. It's too hard a game not to put your heart and soul with the passion and the energy you got to have. You can't just go through the motions. It's not going to work for you.
One guy who I haven't seen go through the motions, you may not have seen this either, is Derwin James. I mean, he had 12 tackles, and he had one of the biggest plays of the second half with that strip fumble.
That was a key, I mean, because it set us up for the three-score lead and got us going that way, and he came out of the game, and just the way he was flying around. And I'm going to tell you what's keep developing on him, his leadership and the impact he's having on those other guys. They all see it. This guy's going to be a special player.
Florida State gets a win, and now we turn the page, move on. There's a small little game we'll talk about when we come back. FSU and Clemson on the horizon. We'll have a preview for you right after this.
My name is Javian Elliott. I'm from Panama City, Florida. I'm a senior at Florida State University, and I play the nickel position. Yes, I think I do remember the first football game I played. I was 5 years old, and I was playing running back. And they just gave me a jersey. I was like, a high number. Basically, sports is like my life. You know, I've been playing sports since I was younger than five, playing basketball, football. I played baseball. I tried to play every sport there was, and really, I just love sports. But you know, my dream job would have to be like coaching outside of sports. But that's sports, you know. So I really don't have a dream job outside of sports. I want to be around sports all my life. I'm the oldest. I have three younger brothers and a little sister, Zora and Tyree, Faith and Jamal. Yeah, I try to be a role model, but looking up to me, I'm actually the shortest out of all my brothers. So all my brothers are like 6'4", 6'3", 6'2", so, you know. But yeah, I definitely try to set a great example for them. Going those 2 years without playing football was rough for me. You know, I had to find a job. I had to, you know, do things that were necessary for me to survive, and it was just tough, man. Like, I basically felt like I was just existing. Like, I was just going through the motions every day, and, you know, I was just ready to get back on the field at any time. Coming in as a walk-on, it's very tough, you know. Like, once you come in, you basically have to earn your respect the hard way. You know, you're not recruited, you don't have any stars. And it's a very tough job. They got you going on the scout team with some of the biggest guys on the team, and you know, you gotta work your way up the ladder. It was great. It was a great feeling. I just felt like the hard work was paying off, and you know, I looked at it as another opportunity to play. I wanted to represent the name on the front of my jersey and the back of my jersey. So, you know, I was just honored to be able to put the uniform on, and I knew that once I had the chance, I would play my hardest. The interception, man, it's like when it happens in practice, you know, it's kind of the same in the game, except for it's live. You know, all the times you catch an interception in practice and it finally happens in a game, you know, the coaches say all the time, if you do it in practice, you do it in the games. And what they said was true.
Off the play action fake. Lamar Jackson looks for the long ball downfield. Got a receiver there. Javion makes the interception at the 15-yard line. Javion Elliott just came into the game. That's how you play free safety, Javion.
Man, it's good to see that my teammates care so much about other people's success. You know, it's not a selfish deal with them. Within my position, PJ Darby, but like as an athlete, I look up to all the guys that has left this university and moved on and set great examples for the younger guys. And then on the team, you know, I look up to leaders, like it don't even have to be leaders, just like teammates that such as like Terrence, LaMarcus. Every level there's a person that stands out to me, and I look up to a lot of those guys.
It's my birthday. Oh, yeah.
The Look Ahead is presented by Farm Bureau Insurance. Win a VIP experience at KnowlesContest.com.
Welcome back to the Jimbo Fisher Show. Coach, big showdown this week in the Atlantic, a double whammy, as you like to call them, against Clemson. But this will be a national spotlight type game and a big opportunity.
It will be. I mean, this division, our side of it, you know, and the ACC has come down this game almost every year. They got a great team. They're playing tremendously well. I mean, we're going to have our hands full. They're scoring 50 points a game. They're stopping everybody, putting the brakes on everybody, good kickers. punters, returners. I mean, they got it all. Dabo does a great job. We, you know, we're going to have our hands full. We got to be ready to play.
They've got a dynamic quarterback, too, who was just starting to play early in his career when they were in Tallahassee last year, and Deshaun Watson.
Big time. I mean, Deshaun, we recruited Deshaun. He can throw it. He can run it. He can lead. He's tough. I mean, he has all the credentials to be a big, big-time player, and he's playing that way right now.
Game kicks off at 3:30 this Saturday in Clemson, South Carolina at Death Valley. We, of course, will have a look back next week right here on the Jimbo Fisher Show. Stay with us, though. Still a little bit more ahead.
The Look Ahead is presented by Farm Bureau Insurance. Win a VIP experience at KnowlesContest.com.
We're right outside the Seminole Sports Nutrition Center with nutritionist Katie Messick. And if anybody's seen the movie Waterboy, you know, not water is not the best option for some people. They just don't like it. They want something different. So when we're done working out, or we are working out, what are some of the options we've got?
Yeah, so we lose a lot of water weight, especially here in Florida. You know, it's very hot during the summer months and as we go into the fall. So we want to replenish all the fluid that we lose. So for somebody who doesn't like that boring water, we have a water infuser here. We cut up some different fruits, citrus and some strawberries. We put it in there. It soaks overnight and gives that subtle flavor to your water that helps kind of maybe easier to drink a little bit more water. Something else, another type of water, we have coconut water. It's been very popular over the last couple years. This has a great source of natural potassium, but it does lack that carbohydrate and sodium component that we look for to kind of help replenish athletes.
Well, we skipped past this pickle juice here.
Yes.
I can smell it from here. What is the best part about this? What is maybe some of the stuff you want to stay away with because of pickle juice?
Yeah, so the pickle juice is going to be very high in sodium. It does kind of give it a little flavor for athletes to drink some if they find that novelty act in it. But it's very high in sodium, so it's going to help replenish that part of if they're a very heavy sweater. But it is a little bit hard to get down if you're not a pickle fan.
Well, as we go closer and closer to you, we've got more electrolyte stuff. What exactly is an electrolyte? I mean, we all hear about it in the sports drinks and whatnot, but what exactly is it for our body?
Yeah, it kind of helps kind of keep your muscles firing and ensure that we have good concentration with our brain function. So we want to ensure that everything is kind of happening on that point, kind of keeping in those electrolytes as best as we can.
So as we go closer to you, what do we have as far as these drinks go?
So this is going to be plain water, and we can kind of flavor it with some electrolyte drops. So if you put in a couple there, it helps flavor the plain water. Keeps your calories in check if you're watching your weight, but still has that carbohydrate as well as the sodium potassium that we look for. This one is more of a pediatric electrolyte. Again, very focusing on the electrolytes like sodium and potassium, but lacking that carbohydrate quality to help replenish fuel stores. And also really focus on the child and not so much the adult athlete. But again, comes in great flavor, so sometimes we can get them to drink this a little bit more often. Over here we have the true sodium carbohydrate potassium sports drink, and this is a one-stop shop for that athlete that's coming off a practice or a hard workout. Somebody again that's watching their calories, we may cut it in half. So this is half water, half sports drink.
So out of all of these options, does it matter? I mean, depending on what activity they've got, what is some of the best ones to do?
We like the all-inclusive one with the sports drink and all. The next one, if we're watching calories, we kind of go this route with the drops. I'm even okay if they choose the coconut water, but we got to make sure they get sodium back in, maybe through their meal, as well as a carbohydrate source to help replenish their muscle stores, so that could also come through their meal. So we can work with whatever they want. We just want to make sure they're getting their fluids back in.
Is there anything that you want people to stay away from, maybe?
Any caffeinated beverages. Some sodas that are a little bit higher in sugar can also have a sugar crash from that, and it doesn't provide any sort of electrolytes. So those two things are something that we try to limit.
Water itself, though, I mean, is that probably the best option?
Absolutely. I think some of our O-linemen, they'll lose up to 15 pounds of water in a practice. So somebody that is losing that much water weight, we don't want to put all water back in them because that will lower their blood levels of electrolytes. So that's when this kind of comes in handy. So we'll make sure that they're getting both in. But the normal recreation athlete may lose 2 to 3 pounds, and then when that water is definitely okay.
Well, we've got so many options here, so many sports drinks to go through. If you need any more information, want to decipher through them, you go to Seminoles.com, go to the nutrition page. We've got it all right there for you. For Katie Messick, I'm Jonathan Schlacey. We'll see you guys next time.
Welcome back to the Jimbo Fisher Show. Coach, we do need to make note that, you know, a guy who's the active winningest coach in college football announced that he's going to retire at the end of the season. Frank Beamer, you obviously know him from competing against him and being a head coach yourself.
Yeah, I mean, Frank is, when you meet Frank, I mean, not only one of the great coaches in college football now or in college football history, but one of the great gentlemen. I mean, does it right. What he's done, what he has done at Virginia Tech is amazing, you know, throughout his career. And, I mean, what a great guy. And it saddens me that the game of college football loses a guy of that quality. But I hope, you know, he's done it a long time. Mm-hmm. I hope he can enjoy his life with his family. And, you know, he's put in his time and the many lives he's affected in such a positive way. It's amazing. And I can say he's one of the great guys in college football history and one of the great gentlemen also.
Good luck to Coach Beamer. Coach, just some final thoughts from you, aside from the obvious of playing Clemson. What else are you working to continue to clean up with your team this week?
Well, I think just the consistency levels. I think, you know, understanding how to practice and how to prepare and, you know, just taking, again, going back to fundamentals of where your eyes are supposed to be because they're such a young team. And just remind them when you have success, why you have success, to repeat that part, the things that we need work on. We're also going to work on our punt coverage right there on that kick and not letting up at the end. I think that was more lack of focus than anything. But, you know, we got in our kicking game, we get Roberto going back again and where he's at. And I think, you know, just not having as many three and out, you know, some things on third down we'll try to pick up and always continue to work on that red zone and try to keep these chunk plays going defensively the same way and just keep great leverage on the football and be able to play these no-huddle teams. We got them and NC State both come up on no-huddle teams that are they go very, very fast.
All right, sounds good. It'll be fun this weekend, Florida State and Clemson, and we'll have a look back at that matchup next week right here on the Jimbo Fisher Show.
This has been the Jimbo Fisher Show, presented by First Commerce Credit Union. Brought to you by First Commerce Credit Union. Now that's local strong. The Florida Lottery, over $28 billion and counting to education. Just imagine. The Florida Department of Transportation, drive sober or get pulled over. The energy-saving conservation programs of Tico People's Gas. Coke Zero, you don't know zero until you've tried it. SunTrust, the official bank of Florida State Athletics. Nick's Toggery, provider of Coach Fisher's wardrobe.